I have a secret gadget collaboration box in here, and big surprise, a 3D printing pen. Welcome to the Ayala Art I Love to Paint channel. This is your artsy friend Martha. If you are art inclined, love painting, drawing, art journaling, and mixed media, this is your channel. So I am participating in this wonderful collaboration organized by Nanny in the Seamstress channel. The link will be in the information box below. And also all the participants are going to be listed in there. All of us are from the CAC and it's going to be a blast. No one knows what they're getting. And I frankly, I'm shocked to see this because I have never, I have never used one. So, well, it is a Merlion printing pen. Drawing your dream. Well, I guess I open it from here. All right, there is little, I guess this is the printing material. I seriously don't know anything about 3D printing pens. A little plastic. Some basic patterns, which are really cute. A manual. The connection. A cute little tool. More cables. Some probably for protecting your fingers somehow. Very tiny fingers. Maybe they have to be snug. I don't know. And the actual pen. Oh, there's some other something here. I will figure out what this little thing is. And so this is the pen. Thank you, Nanny. You got me in trouble. I have no idea what it is. I'm going to have to read all of this. And part of this collaboration is to have an inspiration sentence or phrase. And my inspiration is, I should have warned you that Tom is a little strange. So that's what I have to work with. The secret tool and the phrase. I will be right back to read a little bit of what to do with this based on the little booklet, and then I will do a project with it. So I will be right back. I asked my beautiful creative assistant to help me with this 3D pen project, and our cat was helping from a distance too. You are in good company. He's smelling your leg. Let him smell you. Most extraordinary. So I'm loading up the new color, which means that I have to get rid of the old color. And I learned that blue stains everything. And if you don't use scissors, you'll have plastic hairs all over you. So this is what it looks like. If I can pick it up. This is what it looks like to change colors. It's like a gradient of pink to white. Should I show that one? And then the heat, just like a glue gun, keeps on spitting out little curls of plastic. And if you try to take them off the tip, you burn your finger, which I just did. So I made this, this came with the pack. It's a little bit too slippery in my opinion, so if you get a 3D pen, it's probably worth investing in a silicone mat if you're going to be using it often. And I made a little figurine last night, but I decided today I'd use a sketch. Since the theme is Tom, I figured a cat would be appropriate, and by a cat I mean my cat specifically, whose name isn't Tom, but it'll be. That's just how it's going to be. And why is it so crooked?
it'll have to work straight for the camera, but crooked for me. Okay. So I'm going to put this mat over it and start tracing. I'm going to do it slightly 3D, but with a hollow, flat back, if possible. And I'm starting with the white so that if the black is as stainy as the blue, I won't have to deal with all of my other inks coming out crooked. I mean, not crooked, stained.
Do you want some washi tape to hold the plastic thing?
Yeah, sure. Alright, so I'm going to secure this down with some washi tape. And I will now begin tracing. This controls the speed, so I usually keep it on the lower side because when you go too fast, it's like really fast. And then this is for the temperature, and this is for unloading your ink, which you have to do every time you want to change colors, and this is for spitting out the ink from the front. So you also need to do that when you're reloading the ink, which it was kind of hard to understand from the user's manual. I was like, what does this say? But I figured it out, and it's not that hard, but the manual makes it seem hard. But anyway, I'm going to start now. And I'm going to start at a low speed. And also, if you're left-handed, this screen will forever be upside down for you, so that's what I'm living with. Here we go. Oh, it cooled off because I wasn't using it, so now I need to turn it on again. If you look here, you can see the temperature. I don't know if that shows on a camera. It's kind of blinky, but it shows the temperature rising right there. And I have turmeric fingers, so don't mind my orangeness. So when you pour it out faster, it takes way longer for the plastic to cool. And that can either suck or be really awesome because you can kind of still squish it with your fingers to try to smooth it out a bit. Or alternatively, your creation will begin to melt because it never had the proper cooling time. So it's usually better if you just want to produce it how it is. It's better to work a little bit thinner rather than thicker. But I mean, since this is a cat, I guess it doesn't matter if it's wiggly, because cats have fur. At least most cats do. But, thanks, Mom.
Am I here just for those giggles?
I mean, you're here. Somebody has to laugh.
No way. Okay.
To stop, I keep around a pair of scissors to cut it, even if it's still hot, just because if you don't, it'll leave you with a bunch of hairs, and I don't like that. So I'm gonna let this cool for a second. I'm gonna see if it's still... Oh, it's already pretty hardened. I'm not going to unstick it yet because that will be annoying. And I think I'm going to keep in mind that there's a nose here, and I kind of want to fuse them because if you don't fuse your plastics, there's a risk of it snapping. Even if you're just making, like, say you're spiraling around, trying to make an arm or whatever, if you stop for a second and then start to plan out, like, the hand after that, that'll be a weak point because those plastics weren't from the same heat and the same exact, like, squirting process, so it'll cause like an easy break point, and you don't want your creations to be snapping. I'm going to keep working slightly slower this time. Also, the motor changes like frequency when you change the speed, so at first I thought I broke the thing, but it's not broken. So if you look here, I'll show it to you, there's a little hairy thing right here. You kind of have to cut that off when it's cooler rather than when it's hotter because it gets really hard to snip it. So now that I did that, I'm thinking how I'm going to leave mouthpiece here, so I think I'm going to fill it kind of around in the corners here and then leave it hollow, and then come back later with some teeth and maybe some black to shade in and differentiate between the teeth and the mouth, because it's both the same white, like there's no shades of white or anything. And for that, I might use some more pink, maybe later on.
You can use yellow or green teeth.
He's not that nasty.
No, but you can use just a different color. There's gold.
Gold teeth. That's
gray.
No, I'm thinking maybe I'll trace them with gums.
Yeah.
And then I can make the teeth and then change my mind later without sticking them, so...
Yeah.
We'll see. So I'm going to round this out a little bit, and then I'm going to change inks. I don't want to change inks until I'm ready, because it's very tedious, and I don't want to waste the color. And you can always build more layers on top once it's cool, just to make sure that the shape is what you're going for. I know I'm talking like a pro, but while making this very lumpy thing, but I want you to understand. I want you to understand that it's kind of hard to make this smooth, so that's why they recommend, or by they I mean the one or two sites that I looked at, recommend sanding your product down, your creation. And you should start with a heavy grit or a thick, coarse grit, and then work your way down to the finest one you can. And you shouldn't use Dremels or any tool like that, or like a sanding tool, because this plastic is specifically designed to be easy to melt. So if you start speed sanding, it'll just basically turn your creation into a puree. I've laid some groundwork for putting the nose. See how I kind of stamped that down a bit? I mean, white probably doesn't show very well on the camera, but I pressed that down and it made it a little bit less lumpy, but you can still see the different strands of plastic. So now to unload this, I'm going to press the backwards button. I don't know how it works for other 3D pens, but I'm pretty sure you always have to unload your, I don't know what they call it, ink, perhaps? I think reversing always goes the same speed, but if you're trying to put the ink in, you can go for the fullest setting and it'll go slightly faster by putting this all the way back. But that's just for this pen. And then when I'm drawing this out, usually it'll have a little strand, so I like to pull slowly so that I don't leave it jammed. I'll end up cutting it off anyway, so it's not like I'm saving anything, but I just don't want to leave a bunch of crud inside. So, let me cut this off. And when you're going to reload your ink, it has to have a relatively flat tip so that it fits evenly into the gears. And I'm going to load this new one. Press the forward button. And if you watch the tip, you'll be able to see when it starts to come out. It'll still be the last color you left in this case white, and it'll start to come out more and more dyed the other color. It's usually better to put this aiming towards your wrist, but I wasn't paying attention, so now I have to live with my mistakes. I'm going to put a little nose on here. I guess it won't be too detailed because that won't really come across anyway. Right. I slow down the speed a bit, about halfway. This is pretty much already a good enough nose. To me, this ink kind of smells like hot candy. It has a strangely sweet smell. I think this type of filament is made with some sort of oil from vegetables. I could be mistaken about that. I was doing a little bit of research on whether or not this was the most unenvironmentally friendly thing in modern history, so I did look it up, I just don't remember what I read. So here's the nose. I made it even worse than it was when it first appeared. I made it look bad, but that's just the way it is. So the only other pink I might use would be inside of the ears here. Don't know so far. I'm now going to unload the pink, which was kind of a waste of time. I should have probably done that at the end, but that's okay. You don't need to pull it out, but I like to guide it or just kind of hold it with a little bit of pressure just to make sure it's still coming out. And then right about here, you have to start pulling it out once you hear it stop pulling. I felt it snap, so I think there's still some stuff in there, which might mean that I have to deal with some pink coming out for a while after this. I don't know, we'll see. The black is a pretty strong color, so we'll see if that's even a problem. And now I'm loading in my new ink, this time black. You see how it changed from pink to black? It's already done, so I'm going to cut that off. You can pull it off, you don't really need to use scissors, but I am very annoyed by the little invisible strings. So, I'm going to start now putting this back here and tracing. I might attach it separately, so let's just see what happens. Silicone mat, it would probably have better grip while also being smooth enough to not keep your thing, your creation, stuck to it forever. Because this little plastic that they gave me is like completely textureless, which is easy to remove, but the problem is that it's so easy to remove that I'll still be making a line and the line still attached to my pen will be unsticking already, which kind of sucks. This to the white piece that I made. And this black ink has enough pigment in it to stain if you just touch the tip to the white. So if you're doing what I'm doing with black and white, just be careful if you don't want any stains. I'm not that picky, I don't really care, so I'm gonna go ahead and keep doing as I'm doing. There's lots of different methods you can use that I'm thinking about right now to make anything with a 3D pen. Obviously you can come up with whatever you want, but so far I've tried spiraling up from the bottom and making a creature like how a 3D printer might, by first starting at the base and then working my way up to the top. And then you could do it in the way that I've seen a lot of people do it online, where you kind of trace your creation, you kind of pre-prepare a couple of different angles that you need, so like a square here and a square there, and then you kind of stick them together. But that could, you know, that kind of takes some calculating. I always prefer to do things just straight onto the canvas, or, you know, whatever I'm working on. That's just my personal technique. Like, I do digital drawings. I don't like to sketch. I like to just go in with the line art because I feel like it keeps it more charged and lively. So that's kind of what I'm doing here. It might not be the best idea, and I know that every medium needs its own sort of techniques, but it's still fun, and that's all that counts. So now I need to start planning for where the eye is going to go. Okay. So, I'm going to make this bridge. Alright, so that's filled in. And I'm going to change the ink now to yellow and start trying to make these eyes. I don't know how long it'll take to wash out the black. I know the yellow won't be yellow, same as when you're using markers, and it, you know, you draw over any color with yellow, the yellow kind of stains forever. The more you go, the more yellow it'll become, and you can just keep comparing the end to the tip. The weird thing about this is after working with it molten and thinking of it as soft, you can hear it just makes that typical plastic sound. So it's really weird to know that whatever you made is as solid as a figurine you can get at a store, and yet a lot poorer quality. Isn't that just amazing? So I think I'm just gonna shove this eye in here for now and make another one about the same size. And then fill it in with black, and then I'll figure out what to do next after that. So stay tuned for the same thing you just saw a second time. These are almost exactly the same now. I think I actually ended up making the second one bigger. This is the new one, this is the first one that I made. So one of them is definitely a different yellow than the other, and I don't know if it's because it's still warm or what, but that is okay, I accept that. And my pen's trying to slide off. I'm gonna stick these in here. Alright, so we've got a nice glossy black again, after the yellow, as you can see from the lasso, which is just what I call them. I don't know if there's an actual technical term.
If you're new here, remember to click on the subscribe button and also tick the bell so you get notifications every time I upload a new video. All you will see in the playlist here is acrylic painting, art journaling, all kinds of fun, free paintings and activities.
Now it looks like he's kind of sad. Okay, so yeah, I still regret making the nose, but I'm gonna make it work. I'm gonna use, well, if I switch back to white now, it's going to be a different white. I'm thinking in the ears I might use pink, which I probably should have done at the same time as the nose, but I don't think I was ready for that yet. So I think now is appropriate to do some of the mouth. I think I'll do that with pink instead of black, just because I don't know, maybe I'll do a little bit of black over here, just to fill it in.
There's this beige for the ears.
I'm not gonna use beige for his ears.
Just, I mean, it's supposed to be weird.
I mean, is this not weird?
That's actually cute.
You think this is cute? Okay, I'm going to unload.
Maybe you can put orange for the ears if you want it a little different.
And here's the problem with the filaments they provided, not having a thing rolled onto them. This is so annoying. I placed these by each other and they're like earbuds, you know, they tingle. Oh, I guess I can use this gray for his ears. Okay, I'll do that. All see. Well, I don't want his teeth to be gray, and I don't want them to be yellow, because the yellow is too yellow. So I think I might go with some pink gums, just to separate it from the cheeks, because I know that the teeth aren't going to end up looking like teeth, so I'm going to prepare ahead of time. So transitioning from gray to white was a lot easier. It went a lot faster changing from gray to white. So now I'm going to, I guess this is about 2 fingers wide, so from this stain to over here, I need to do some teeth. So I'm gonna try to just kind of make some teeth, or at least lay the groundwork for them. This looks like it'll fit pretty well. I'm gonna make it a little wider so that I can sort of bend it while it's hot, and then stick it in there. And then I'm going to do the same thing and do that, put it like directly underneath. Oh, that should be okay for now. So I'm going to, that looks fantastic actually. I'm going to fill in up here with some pink for the gums. I really hope that doesn't just blend in with the nose. And then I think in the background I'll probably either do more pink or black, just to make it look deep without leaving a hole. If I had thought ahead of time, I could easily turn this space here into a coin slot, but there's not enough room now, so oh well. Live and learn. I'll have to wait until the future to make a coin slot out of this strange cat's face. The reason I go so far past any glimpse of pink to like definitely pink is just because I don't want to start something that might show on the surface and then you can see like a gradient between the different shades. I want it to be as consistent as possible, just because that's my personal preference for coloring. So now I'm going to start filling in from here using the fastest speed, trying to make it look a little smoother than not. Okay, well, that is just terrible. Ow, I burned myself. That is wonderfully bad. So I'm going to keep going and doing the same thing I just did. Repeating my mistakes. So this pink actually came out different than the pink of the nose. I don't know if it shows on camera, but it's like a more pastel pink rather than a reddish pink. So who knows if that'll change as it cools. This is... It looks like his cheeks are full of gum. Can you see that? That's just great. That's wonderful. Camera quality is just as good because I had to set it up myself, and the main camera ran out of memory card room, and it's not my camera, so even though I've been shown many times how to use it, I still have no idea. So I'm going to finish this off right now. Let me see if you can see what I'm doing. Yeah, it's pretty good, right? Alright, so I'm just going to try a little experiment here where I give this cat some horrible little whiskers. Probably should have started with the thinnest ink. Anyway, I'm just gonna hold that until it cools.
And basically when it's dry, I expect that's going to be horribly sharp. So I'm waiting for this to, yeah, there we go. See, now it's cool. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that a couple more times. Let me turn down the speed. Oh, this is grotesque. So these could easily break off at any moment, but I figured just for the completion of this project on camera, I'm gonna just go ahead and keep doing it. I'm trying to blow on it to cool it faster so I don't have to hold the pen for so long. Oh, this is horrible. Imagine if I just broke them all off right then. This is just horrible. Okay, now to do a couple more. Watch me pass out on camera from hyperventilating. The worst part is that these hairs, like, I don't know if you can see them on camera, but there's these hairs just keep going forever, so these are more like nightmarish tentacles. Alright, turning this off now. I'm gonna leave it in a safe area to cool while the cord falls to the ground. I'm gonna trim off some of these nightmarish hairs coming off of the whiskers. So here is the final product. I really, really should have warned you how strange this guy was going to be, but honestly, I couldn't even warn myself because I thought it was going to be kind of cute. I mean, look at this. What do you think? Well, thanks for watching. I think I'm supposed to do a heart, if I can. Does that work? Bam. I'm sure my mom will do a better intro.